Dr. Denis Burke, and today I want to talk to you about the intuitive mind. You know, our intuition is one of the great powers that's within us. It's one of six intellectual faculties, and our intellectual faculties are really part of our higher intelligence. Now, just like we have muscles in our body, you know, you could exercise your muscle in your arm and you get much more effect and more benefit from your arm. You can do exactly the same with your intuition and your other intellectual faculties. But since today I'm talking about the intuitive mind, then I'm just going to speak to you about intuition. So the idea is that the more you use your intuition, the more you train it, the more beneficial it becomes. It is kind of like a muscle in your mind. So just like the arm, you can use it more and get more benefit from it. Now, our intuition is a very, very vital part of our well-being because it is how we sense everything around us. We sense things like danger, we sense good and bad, we sense everything just about in our environment comes as a result of our intuition. Now, we can sense our intuition just because it's one of these great powers we have, but it tells us a lot also about the people that we interact with. And just from 10, 20 feet away, you can sense people, and it has to do with that intellectual or intuitive factor. Now also you can sense things from a distance from your intuition. Actually thousands of miles away, you can sense what people are feeling or thinking. And even if there are barriers or walls, it has no bearing on your ability to interpret intuition from a distance. For example, you see on TV various psychics. And what psychics really are people who have developed a very high sense of intuition. And then therefore, they're able to tap into this high level of intuitive sense, their higher power, if you will, to be able to tell you about current events or about future events and things happening with people and situations. Now, I want to tell you a story about myself that gives you an example of how important your intuition is and how, if you follow it, it can have dramatic changes in your life. You see, for over 25 years, I've been successful in my life and many different kinds of businesses. But down deep inside me, there always was this inkling, if you will, this voice of source within that said, hey, you need to become an inspirational, motivational, professional speaker. You need to write books and become an author. And you need to mentor and guide people in the millions. And I sort of set that idea aside within me for many, many years, probably more years than I should have. And then in the last few years, this voice started to scream at me inside, kind of like the sheriff coming banging at your door. It was that loud within me. And see, when you get a calling like that and your intuitive power within is shouting at you so hard, you really have to listen and you really have to act. And so I did. I decided, therefore, to reinvent myself and to recreate my purpose and my path for the rest of my life, which then, therefore, puts me in front of this camera teaching people about new ideas and inspiring people to do better in their lives, and also to work on creating books, materials, and educational content for people so that they can improve their lives. I discovered because of my path and following this calling that I have new energy, new passion, new excitement in my life. And I certainly cannot explain the power of serenity and peace of mind that I have since I responded to this intuitive call. Also, I want to share with you briefly a thought from Steve Jobs, who at the Stanford address in 2005, he He talked about his life. He picked a few sections of his life, and he mentioned about finding his purpose. And so what I want to say is that he recognized that early in his life, he discovered about his technological orientation, his interest in gadgetry. And even though he talked in that video or in that address about his purpose in life and finding it, what he was really also wanting to tell us is that you should not be bogged down by people's dogma, which is the results of other people's thinking. And he also went on to say that you should not allow others' opinions drown out your inner voice. And then he went on to say, but most of all, no, follow your intuition, because somehow it knows what you are supposed to become. And to that, everything else is secondary. So I want to encourage you now to listen to your inner voice, your intuition. Develop it to a much higher level, and then you will find your life will be guided in a whole new direction, in a new way, and you will be grateful that you do. This is your moment of wisdom from Dr. Denis Burke.